Today we are going to see from Proverbs 25:25. Good news from a distant land is like cold water to a weary soul. What is a good news? Who doesn't want a good news? Good news is something that brings you joy. How beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news of gospel, says the word of God. Every perfect and good gift is from above, from the Father of heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. James 1:17 it is. So good news, it is like cold water to a weary soul. When you're outside in the hot sun the whole day, and when you get back home, you quickly go grab a cup of water. A cup of water, cold water, how does it feel like, you know, to a thirsty throat, thirsty mouth? It refreshes you, revives you. Just like that, a good news from the distant land, okay, it refreshes, revives you, gives you the joy, okay, the long awaited promotion that comes in the mailbox from the head office saying you are promoted. It's a good news. Good news always comes through some messenger. It can be an angel, it can be a person or a mailbox communication. You know, you need some intermediary to deliver the good news to you, isn't it? Okay, so let's see from Numbers chapter 14, a good report brought by Joshua and Caleb to the Israelite assembly. In Numbers 14:7, we could see the land we passed through and explored is exceedingly good. This was the report, a good report in fact, brought by Joshua and Caleb. Moses sends 12 tribes of Israelite to explore the land of Canaan. Let's see from Numbers chapter 13 verse 1. The Lord said to Moses, send some men to explore the land of Canaan, which I am giving to the Israelites. So from each tribe, send one of its leaders. So Moses sent 12 of them. Okay. Two people. Two were Joshua and Caleb. Caleb from the tribe of Judah and Joshua from the tribe of Ephraim. Okay. He is mentioned as Hoshea, son of Nun. Later, Moses renamed him as Joshua. So don't confuse with that. Both are same, okay? So from these 12 tribes, they go and explore the land of Canaan, okay? And let's see what is their perspective. The 10 tribes, except for Joshua and Caleb, they had a different perspective in exploring the land. The report they gave was slightly different because their faith level is different from Joshua and Caleb. Joshua and Caleb had more focus on God, on the strength of God, rather than on themselves or the strength of the Israelite troop. Okay, in verse 27, they gave Moses this account. We went into the land to which you sent us, and it does flow with milk and honey. Here is its fruit. But the people who live there are powerful, and the cities are fortified and very large. Okay, they see the threat in the land, the people, the giants, their power. So these things bring a threat to them. It discourages them to moving into the promised land, which actually God has put before them. So these 10 people had a different report, but Caleb silenced the people before Moses and said we should go up and take possession of the land. He gave encouragement, he gave confidence. Okay, and in chapter 14:7, Joshua and Caleb, you know, they become frustrated and they tore their clothes looking at the negativity in the people, in the eyes of the people, the threat they see in the promised land. They felt very frustrated and they tore their clothes and said, the land we explored is exceedingly good land. Exceedingly meaning tremendously, distinctly, supremely good and awfully good, okay? So that was the report, because they thought like with the strength of the Lord, they will be able to scale up the wall and overcome the enemies, overcome the power of the people, the threat of the people in the land. When Moses sent the people, the 12 tribes, to explore the land, he gave a set of questions to them, just like a research survey, okay? One of the important process, step in the research process is to setting up the research questionnaire for the survey. Moses gave us, gave a similar thing to the people who went to explore the land. He actually told them to explore how big is the land. The questions were, see what the land is like and whether the people who live there are strong or weak, few or many, what kind of land they live in, good or bad, what kind of towns they live in, are they unwalled or fortified, how is the soil, is it fertile or poor, are there trees in it or not, and also he said, do your best to bring some fruit from the land. So that's what the tribes did. They brought a huge cluster of grapes, you know, which they couldn't carry in one hand. Two people actually have to carry a cluster of grapes. Well, the cluster was so heavy and huge because the land is a fertile land, a prosperous land with a lot of good fruits and trees, and the yield was extremely good, okay? So that they took a sample fruit and they brought before him and said, the land indeed is good, but you know, people who live there are very powerful. Whereas Joshua had a complete good report. Joshua and Caleb never focused on the weaknesses, negativity or the threat. They focused more on God in their side, and with God what they can do, and with God how they can be victorious and take possession of the land. That was their perspective, their focus, okay? Today I encourage you to focus on God on your side. With him you can scale a wall. The good news you are awaiting for from the distant land is coming to you, and be thankful to him today and stay blessed. Stay tuned for more on Faith Bits.